Yeah, my name is Ralf Neb. I'm the CTO of GameDuel, and I would like to talk about real-time, near-time analyzers with iTube and VoltDB. It's a presentation, quite an overview presentation, how we solved it. It's not too technical. We made the decision to get more onto the overview information and more into the direction how our approaches are evolving. So, first of all, what is GameDuel? GameDuel is a company located in Berlin. We are doing games, in casual games. We are doing real cross-platform, means we are available on our own platform where you can play for money. We are available on Facebook with our social games, and we are available on our mobile platforms, mainly on Android and iOS. But we are as buzzwords, and so we should talk about technology, right? First of all, I would explain the need we have. It was articulated from our business development, and mainly four different requirements. Was the first requirement, analyze all our events in on every platform, means we have to analyze our core platform, we have to analyze our social platform, new friend, whatever, all the things like that, and we have to analyze our mobile events. So making analysis afterwards to calculate the value of a user, to calculate what to show, and the next requirement was mainly to simplify the kind of operations, because we do not want to build up several queues, for example, the most important queue and the more important queue and the unimportant queue, because it's a mess in operation. So every event should be handled like the most prior event. And that's the reason why we have a lot of different abstraction layers to handle. It means an alert thrown by a system, for example, disk full, front end failed, whatever. Also, a click on our website means you start a game. And a conversion means getting from a probe gamer to from beginner to a gambler backend in the backend, and payment is also such an event. Next requirement was decide in real time, so it was very, very important that every decision the system has to take is done in less than 150 milliseconds, because only in such a time period you are able to query the rule engine in the time during the request. Where you will use something like that, A/B testing, optimized flows, for example, Amazon will suggest a new game to you, for example. And last but not least, that's the reason why we are at Buzzword. Scalability is crucial, because we think that a successful real-time engine will multiply our events on factor 10, 100, 150, like that. So we have to take care that we are able to handle a lot of more load. So, we talked about decisions. Decisions are mainly done on our platform in three different ways. Means a decision is something like, is a user in a split test group, and is it able to see a different feature? It's also necessary to analyze the events of the different feature showed to the user at the end. So here you see why we have to take care of a lot of events. Global context. Why it's a global context? Every decision is the same on mobile, on social, and on our own platform. That's not so common in the industry right now. There are many solutions like that for one platform, but not for the whole cross-platform experience. A rule is interpreted every time with different facts. So a fact is a result computed in our Hadoop environment. For the first time, it's computed once per month, which is not very sophisticated. Okay, you can do it once per week, but also not very sophisticated. And that's the reason why we try to do a near-time, real-time, means we want to achieve facts in a recent time frame, which is not older than 5 minutes. So the initial requirements, I will not repeat the whole stuff why we should use Hadoop. I would expect that every one of you is aware of the advantages of Hadoop. So we did the iteration zero, which means our basic approach was not done very sophisticated. It was just a solution, because we think it's very important to make it up and running very, very fast and to break things early. So our app servers send out the events via syslog into one box, and the syslog was the aggregation filter to write down all the events into one file. We have different problems, but learnings coming on another slide. The event log was then moved into the Hadoop cluster and imported into the HDFS. After the import, the MapReduce job starts, read the whole data, map it, reduce it, store it back into the HDFS. After that, our initial query was done, and we did it for the first time to ask the HDFS directly. Yes, I know on the HDFS side, it's mentioned explicitly HDFS is done for block for block files and for block processing, and not optimized for latency. But yeah, it was a try, and as we, as I said before, we will come to the learnings on the next slide. So, just a plain Hadoop setup, nothing new, and at its that, it's also not scaling. So, nothing won so far. What was our learning? Our learning was, UTP is for sure not reliable. You do not know anything if events are lost, you do not get an error message, whatever, and the random I/O caused by the syslog is also very, very hard to handle. Sure, it's also not made for this. So we have to address two different points. We need more reliability, and we need to cushion our random I/O. That was the reason why we decided to use VoltDB instead of syslogd. VoltDB is a very clean and small implementation of in-memory database, and it's just one implementation. You can also use alternatives for such an in-memory database. So HANA from SAP is one alternative, and the other one is from Oracle times 10. Depends on your budget and whether you believe in Oracle or not. So means we slightly modified our procedure. Right now, all events are written into the VoltDB, an idempotent job in the Hadoop cluster was able to get all the data from the VoltDB, import it into the HTFS, run the MapReduce job, everything's fine so far, okay. After that, result stored in HTFS and in VoltDB, because so it was possible to ask the VoltDB for future queries and to get the new facts recalculated every 5 minutes or every 100,000 events, whatever comes first. It's just a configuration. So we solved our random I/O and latency problem, but we did not solve our problems with our sequential I/O. The sequential I/O was still very high because we have to put in 100,000 events every time when the idempotent job runs. So the overall sequential I/O was too high to scale out. So let's have a look on the next thing. Was a very simple idea we had in the past with the VoltDB in the front end. We can also do the same trick in the back end too. Means we do not have to import our raw data directly into the HTFS. We can also use it directly from our MapReduce job. And the MapReduce job will then only store the result directly into the Hadoop cluster and so into the HTFS. So a lot of I/O is saved. We reduced our load and I/O up to 80% for the sequential I/O. We got rid of the complete random I/O. And also, a nice thing, we are able to hide the whole Hadoop cluster behind the VoltDB infrastructure. So it's not longer it's not longer needed to know how the data is processed. So we can change it to different implementations. We can use other approaches too, and make the operations and the handling of the architecture more easy. So that's the reason why we think in-memory DBs is an appropriate way to getting back into the driver's seat. Means a lot of data is analyzed right now on different large data sets, and I/O is always the bottleneck. For sure, in-memory DB will not be the silver bullet and will not be the answer to all questions we have. But in our case, it solved a lot of our infrastructure problems in a very easy and very convenient way. So to summarize, we reduced our sequential I/O up to 80%. We got rid of the whole random I/O, and we achieved a guaranteed response time less than 150 milliseconds for a semi near time, a real time approach with our facts, and we are able to recalculating our facts every 5 minutes or every 100,000 events, which is very good number in direct comparison to other competitors. And last but not least, we delivered our promise to scale out the infrastructure completely horizontal. So we are able to put in a lot of more VoltDBs. We are able to put in a lot of more workers for our Hadoop infrastructure. And that's the reason why we think it's a valid approach, and we are looking forward to the Hadoop project, and maybe it's also possible to implement a direct way to address in-memory DBs instead of HDFS only. So, I hope you enjoyed the talk so far, and it's a very short talk, and was the main purpose was just to give an idea how to solve such a problem in a very easy way. And yeah, now
thank you. Other questions? Any questions? So I have maybe one question. What kind of analysis jobs can you run on your VoltDB instances, and what do you do in Hadoop?
Okay, so VoltDB instance itself, it's just a way to cache our events. It will just store all the events coming into it, order it, and set it. And the MapReduce job will directly address, will directly get the data from the VoltDB. It's ordered, it's classified very roughly, and so you just can calculate it and put the result into the HDFS.
All right. So let's thank the speaker again.